So we're going to check out Flomo today. It's a minimal note-taking application with handy ways to record and capture stuff. This is my first product review for a while, so let's dive into today's video. So to start out, this application is pretty notable because it won the Product Hunt Golden Kitty Award 2021 for mobile applications. And obviously it's got an iOS, a Google Play, a Mac, a PWA version, and a web version, in which we have in front of us here. So this application is designed around the Zettelkasten method, something that I'm not too versed in, but I'm going to give you an overview of how it operates and works, and really recommend near the end of this video how and where this is suitable for. So Flomo is a combination of flow and memo. They're trying to combine the two words, so just to give you a little bit of background about the naming. So here on the web version, you can see that my account has a simple note-taking system where I can start typing my notes away, and here's one I created earlier. Now, naturally, I can start creating tags for it, I can start adding images to it, I can use, even on iOS, the live text function to be able to say stuff to it, and it's even got some annotation as well, which allows you to create relationships between certain links. But as you can imagine, it's very basic in terms of its note-taking abilities. Even on the iOS and Google Play Store versions, they're very much designed to record and move on as you take your notes across the day, and nothing too in-depth in terms of more file-orientated notes that you may be having. So as you can see, your account is called Memo, and the synchronizations works across all of the accounts, and naturally that's something I found pretty decent. When I signed into the iOS version, everything synced pretty rapidly between the two. Now, as I said, you can organize stuff through simple tags, and you can also create a sub-tag structure too, which might be handy when it comes to managing through the Zettelkasten method. You can also do something called, connecting WeChat. You scan the QR code and follow the Flomo account, and essentially every message that you send to the official account can be synced there, which is something we've seen in more modern applications like Mem, allowing you to save texts and ideas that come across the day into your note-taking application pretty fast. Now, one thing I'd say is the special functionality probably has to be this heat map. It's something I've also seen in applications like SuperNotes, but it does and looks really nice, especially if you're going to use this as your daily note taker. The heat map allows you to see how many memos you created specifically on one day. And to be honest, I really like this function, and it's something I'd love to see in more note-taking applications. Now, jumping over to the iOS version. Now, in my opinion, it's a really well-created application, and I like their integration of live text inside of there. I also like the little plus button at the bottom, which allows you to take a very simple note just using that quick capture function. And to be honest, if you're somebody that uses WeChat a lot, I could probably see this integration working pretty well on mobile devices. I'm currently using their Pro account, in which I want to explain the pricing a bit more. So their Pro account is $90.99, and as you can imagine, it's much more for better and more frequent note takers. They actually add inside of this 10 gigabytes of image storage and the ability to upload original image sizes. Then you also get the WeChat input via voice, which is good for capturing audio on the go. And also the likes of daily review, a backlink ability, tag icon, and API. And apparently they've already had people build the API for being able to send stuff from Kindle and Notion. Aside from that, you pretty much get unlimited abilities in terms of text records and data export, and some of the basic WeChat stuff too, which you can find in the free plan. So looking at this application, I'd probably say it's best for those who want something that's upgraded from Google Keep, but follows a methodology like Zettelkasten. To be honest, I was impressed with features like the heat map and of course so the WeChat function, because if you were using that quite a lot, I think that would be handy. But I'm actually sort of a bit of an anti-climax from some of the original images. The mobile application works well, and that is great to see, but I'm not greatly impressed with some of the text formatting abilities that you can have on this application. But then again, it is a minimal experience. So at the same time, it's not trying to do as much as some of the bigger applications. To be honest, the pricing isn't too bad. $20 a year is just a little over what they price Bear. But at the same time, it's not something grossly overpriced. And as you can imagine, something that would put you entirely off upgrading to the Pro account. So this application does look interesting, and I think it's also grabbed a large target market in China. I will put the information down in the description below if you fancy checking it out, but I'll probably give this application a C rating. As you can imagine, A star, A, B, C, and D is our sort of ranking system. So I wouldn't necessarily rank it amazingly as a daily note taker compared to some of the other alternatives out there. Anyway, folks, I hope you enjoyed this feature of FLOMO. You might not get FOMO from you missing this one, but at the same time, I hope it gave a good overview of the product. Thank you very much, folks, and I hope you have a fantastic day. Cheers, folks.